And new at 6 o'clock, jurors in the trial of Richard Poplawski, the man accused of killing three Pittsburgh police officers, see detailed forensic evidence outlining the bullet wounds those men suffered. Good evening, I'm Wendy Bell, in for Michelle Wright.
I'm Andrew Stocky. Channel 4 Action News reporter Bob Mayo has been in the courtroom all day long. He's live downtown right now with the details. Bob?
An emotional range of evidence in this courtroom today, ranging from explicit autopsy photos of one of the fallen officers to how authorities were tracking Richard Poplawski's actions leading up to the killings of these three police officers. A medical examiner autopsy doctor showed on this template eight places Officer Paul Schullo was hit by gunfire. I spotted Poplawski, who normally looks away, taking quick glimpses of the actual detailed autopsy photos and x-rays. Another medical examiner's witness presented this animation of how Poplawski's semi-automatic handgun works. When defense attorney Lisa Middleman objected, Judge Jeffrey Manning told prosecutor Mike Tranquille, quote, "The next time you offer up anything Ms. Middleman hasn't seen, it's going to be excluded." Just 5 months before the officers' killings, evidence Poplawski was posing with his deadly weapons. Police found these on his laptop computer. Surrounded by his arsenal of weapons and ammo, he's transfixed on his computer's screen. This photo, gripping his AK-47 assault rifle, dressed in a shirt and tie, posing in a bathroom. You can see in this one he's wearing his bulletproof vest and holding his semi-automatic handgun. Computer evidence also shows hours before the officers were killed, Poplawski logged into the white supremacist website forum called Stormfront. More photo evidence, Poplawski's remote Clarion County campsite with his private shooting range, gunfire-riddled objects, including a target nailed to a tree. A mix of shell casings and live ammo, not fired, sits on this chair. Prosecution's now working through what they believe will be the last 17 of a total of 44 witnesses. Judge Manning confirmed for me today he expects to hold a full day of this trial on Saturday and a trial day on Sunday as well, although possibly only starting in the afternoon. Reporting live downtown, Bob Mayo, Channel 4 Action News.